Okay, if I could have everybody's attention, we're going to go ahead and get started with tonight's activities. First of all, thank you for coming. It's really good to see everybody. And thanks to Robin for inviting me back. This is my third year doing the MC, so thank you. Either Robin thinks I'm pretty good at this, or there was no one else that would take the job. Anyway, either way, I'm delighted to be here tonight. One thing I'd like to mention is I was an athlete at one time myself. I know it doesn't necessarily look like it today, but at one point I played football. And it's not the kind of football that you play maybe in the American context. You know, the football here where you have the oblong shaped ball and you throw it, use your hands, and you have three different teams, the defensive team, the offensive team, and then the special teams team and all that. The football I played was the football that the rest of the world plays. And all my international students would know what I mean, you know. You use your head and you use your chest and your foot, and it's really amazing stuff. The point I would like to make tonight, though, is I never got an award. Yeah? And it would have been nice to get an award. The Irish aren't very good at recognizing each other and giving awards. In America, you're obsessed with awards. There is an obsession with awards. You recognize everybody. And I find that one of the most attractive features of the American race, the American culture. You love awards. And it seems like yesterday, we were here last year, just a year ago, and we handed out dozens of awards. It was amazing. Yeah, and here we are just a year later, and we're handing out a lot more awards tonight. And I just think that's something to celebrate in and of itself, that we are a culture that likes to recognize each other and give awards. And I'm not sure if there's an award for emceeing, but there could be. Yeah. Now, athletes, relax, because every single one of you is going to get an award tonight, yeah? Some awards are a bit better than the other awards, but you're still going to get something. And if you don't, I brought a bunch of lollipops. I'll give you something later on, so you don't go away empty-handed. Yeah? A couple of points before we move forward. If you are nominated, just being nominated, that in and of itself is a real honor. Yeah, if you're in the top three nominees, that's spectacular. You're special. Yeah, just to be recognized. Now, there's only one winner, of course. So if you get second or third place, I'm sorry. You did your very best, and sometimes your best simply isn't enough. So there's one winner tonight, and we look forward to see who that winner is so that we can celebrate with the winner. Now, a couple of instructions, and I'm going to read these because they're very specific. We will follow the order as listed in the program. As the presenters come forward for each award, nominees will be announced. As the winner is announced, we would like to ask that you come up on the stage, receive your award, and then make your way over to me. I'll be standing here most of the evening. Actually, I'll be sitting there, standing there, up and down the whole evening. And my role is simply to ask you just a couple of questions. Yeah, how did you get this award? What does it mean to you? Simple things like that, okay? So that's the way it's going to roll this evening. Welcome, and let's get started with prayer.
If you'll bow your heads with me. Dear Heavenly Lord, thank you so much for this lovely evening that you have bestowed upon us. Thank you for allowing us to come together as different sports to celebrate the gifts that you have given us. Thank you for successful years, new friendships. And let us just remember to always and constantly give you the glory. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
1, 2, 3, everybody just... J.B.U. you know it. I'm gonna let you know. One day, for no particular reason, I decided to go for a little run. So I ran to the end of the road. When I got there, I thought I'd maybe run to the end of Siloam Springs. I figured since I got this far, maybe I'd just run across the great state of Arkansas. And that's what I did. I ran clear across Arkansas. No particular reason. I just kept on going. When I got tired, I slept. When I got hungry, I ate. And when I had to go, you know, I went. I ran clear to the ocean. And when I got there, I figured since I'd gone this far, might as well turn around and keep on going.
On his fourth trip across America, Forrest Gump makes his way across the great state of Arkansas. Forrest, can you tell us why you're running? Is it for women's rights?
Scholarships?
The great state of America?
Better cat food?
Women's rights?
Hot tub in J. Alvin.
The longevity of ducks?
I just felt like running.
For some reason, what I was doing seemed to make sense to people. So I got company. And after that, I got more company. And then, even more people joined in. Somebody later told me it gave people hope. Nah, I don't know anything about that. My mama always said, you gotta put the past behind you before you can move on. And I think that's what my running was all about. I had run for 2 years, 7 months, 22 days, and 16 hours.
Be quiet, I think he's gonna say something.
I'm pretty tired. I think I'll go home now.
And just like that, my running days was over. So I went home to Arkansas.
Now, at this time, we would like to recognize all first-year letter award winners. As your name is called, please come forward in the order your name is called to pick up your award. Matthew Minner, Nathan Kuykendall, Jacob Bach, Lauren Pellegrine, Bailey Cameron, Presley Reese, Allie Pack, Brittany Smith, Nisha White, Marquise Waller, Jake Caudill, Joshua Rodius, Brandon Joseph, Ben Smith, Josh Bowling, Lauren Marsh, Annika Boz, Anna Brown, Tanada Oliveira, Ann Metz, Melody Hagen, Justin Redman, Aspen Robinson, Britt Weisner, Ryan Williams, Connor Haney, Corey Ferguson, Giovanni Bejarano, Santiago Venegas, Kelvin Omondi, Ashby Clark, David Moots, James Pollard, Jorge Sea, Axel Betancourt, Carly Coney, Aaron Green, Tori Kraft, Haley Newcomb, Reagan Roth, Jacob Benjamin, Michael Gaines, Jacob Sinek, Josh Uzalak, Elizabeth Bjornson, Kennedy Shelstead, Bailey Reagan, Bailey Sager, Brittany Ayers, Bethany Maddox, Claire Grant, Madison Spence, Bethany Tiffin, Melissa Wadley, Gage Parker, Tristan Cadell, Thatcher Radler, Annika Hedstrom, and Andy Ish. Now, please welcome to the stage Coach Ken Carver and Coach Kathleen Paulson as they present the Female and Male Freshman of the Year Awards.
Oh, Ken, the journey of freshman year.
You can tell this isn't canned or anything. Yes, it is a series of firsts. You know, sometimes, like, first time you have to do laundry on your own.
First time you run the dreaded fitness tests.
The first time you have to wake up on your own, or maybe not wake up on your own.
The first time you realize you can bomb an exam and get below a 50.
Your first time that you get to start and pull on that JBU jersey and run out on the field, that first goal, basket, all those things.
My favorite was looking at the seniors in the training room and thinking, man, they are so dramatic right now. But then reality sets in.
Yeah, it would be something similar to maybe this. The transformation from freshman year to senior year can be quite telling in a lot of ways. Congressional Basketball League, Presidential Basketball League. But beyond that, we're here to present and honor two special freshmen here for freshman year of the war, freshman year, I'll get it right, freshman of the year, there we go. They're given to two freshmen who've played significant roles for their teams during their first year wearing the blue and gold.
Here are the nominees for female freshman of the year.
Volleyball player Bethany Maddox. Bethany was asked to play a position in back row defense, which she had zero experience in, and ended up doing a great job this season. She was fifth on the team in total digs and digs per set, and was fourth on the team in service aces. Basketball player Bailey Cameron. Bailey was named Sooner Athletic Conference Freshman of the Year and NAIA All-American Honorable Mention. She led the SAC in field goal percentage and was ninth in the NAIA. Cameron finished the season with 401 points and 220 rebounds and paced the Golden Eagles in average scoring with 12.9, rebounding 7.1, rejection 17, and field goal percentage 53.1%. She also finished second on the squad in three-point shooting at 40.5%. Soccer player Jastin Redman. Jastin was the SAC Freshman of the Year and the leading goal scorer for the Golden Eagles. The striker posted 14 goals and 8 assists, a total of 36 points, and tallied 4 game-winning goals, including a perfect 4-for-4 mark from the penalty marker. Redmond's 36 points is tied for third all-time, while her 2.12 sets a new single-season program record. She also set another single-season program record with 0.824 goals per game, and her 13 goals finishes tied for fourth place all-time in a single season.
And the winner of Female Freshman of the Year is Bailey Cameron.
Congratulations, Bailey. Well done. I have a feeling that this is the award that every single freshman wants to win. Am I right?
Yeah.
Very good. What's going through your head right now, just having this award in your hands here?
I'm just really thankful for the opportunity that I got this season. Yeah.
Oh, very good. Now, I'm looking at the stats here. 401 points, 220 rebounds, and an average score of 12.9. How do you get an average score of 12.9? How does that work?
You just shoot a lot, I guess.
So are these stats like really good?
I guess.
Not very good. One last question, Bailey. Is this something that you can improve on the next season?
I think so, yeah.
Well done. Congratulations, Bailey.
All right, congratulations, Bailey. And now for the nominees for the Male Freshman of the Year.
Men's tennis player Nathan Kuykendall. Nathan has had a solid freshman year, playing number 4 singles and number 2 doubles this season. Nathan is currently 5-4 in both singles and doubles with one regular season match to go before regionals. A bright future is ahead for JBU tennis with Nathan in the lineup. Now, men's soccer player Giovanni Bejarano. Gio was first team all-conference and was considered by many coaches to be one of the best defenders in the conference. Gio played in every game, one of only 4 players to do so, and he started all but one game during the season. And men's cross-country runner, Josh Uzalak. Josh is the first JBU runner to qualify for nationals in cross-country since the program restarted 6 years ago, and only the third runner in JBU history to qualify for cross-country nationals. He finished 122nd in the 328-runner field at the 2015 NAIA National Cross-Country National Championships in Charlotte, North Carolina. Josh led the JBU team in all 6 races during the season.
And your freshman, male freshman of the year is Josh Uzalak.
Well done, Josh. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, what's going through your mind right now after winning this award?
I'm hungry.
Yeah. What goes into making this award possible? Like, what do you do other than run?
We just eat a lot, and I don't know. We just joke around a lot and keep our minds off the running.
And what will you be doing the rest of this year and during the course of the summer? Do you stay in shape? Do you stay running?
Yeah, we'll be running in the summer, but yeah, we'll probably just be preparing for next season. So, yeah.
Very good. Well done. Congratulations, Josh.
Thank you.
Yep.
Now, please welcome to the stage Philip Todd and Krizana Saucedo as they present the Newcomer of the Year Award.
As most of us have experienced, being the new guy on the block is a pretty difficult time. A lot is expected of you, and to really stand out, you have to outperform everybody.
The newcomer of the year is for a transfer who has just completed their first year of play for JBU and made an immediate impact for their team.
Over this last year, we've seen some pretty great newcomers, such as Bill Silberman, the CEO of Pinterest. This is his first year as a billionaire.
We have 21 Pilots. We have The Weeknd and Daya, who broke out this year with their new music. We have Jameis Winston, who had a spectacular first year in NFL. Leicester City, for the Premier League followers out there.
And of course, in the political realm, we have Donald Trump. In the same category, here are nominees for Newcomer of the Year, athletes who have truly made JBU great again.
Women's basketball player Cody Powell. Cody led the Golden Eagles in assists and averaged 10 points per game this season. She was named honorable mention all-conference and played the most minutes on the team. Cody ranked first in total assists in the SAC while ranking 13th in the NAIA. She was also 19th in the nation in three-point shots made. Men's soccer player Hazley Pyle. Hazley started 10 games this season while playing in 15. Left back is not a very stat-heavy position, but Hazley was the top transfer in the voting for the conference newcomer of the year. Men's basketball player Luke Moyer. Luke finished the season leading the team with 15 points per game, and he hit 39.1% of his attempts from behind the arc. His 92 triples were the 11th most in the NAIA this season, while his 3.07 triples per game were 7th best in the nation. Moyer capped off his collegiate career by earning all Sooner Athletic honorable mention honors.
And the winner,
For the newcomer of the year award
is Cody Powell.
Well done, Cody. In a few words, tell us how you've enjoyed your year at JBU.
It's been awesome. I just love that I picked this school to come to.
I'm glad you picked it as well. Now, when you look at all these awards, is this the award that you set out to win?
Yes, for sure.
Now, as I look at your stats here, you led the Golden Eagles in assists of, what, average 10 points per game this season. That's really good. Yeah?
Yeah.
Are you pleased with that?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, and do you think you can do better next year or push that up to 12? Or
yeah.
Is it?
Yes.
Okay. Well, thanks for coming. Thanks for being here. And congratulations on the award.
Now, please welcome to the stage Coach Jeff Soderquist and Coach Doug Turner as they present the Comeback Athlete of the Year Award.
All right. So you're young, and all you athletes out there talking about how your great accomplishments and how much fun your particular sport is. But when you get your old card, and there's a few coaches, we won't name them, but I guess we could start with Todd if we were going to name them. That when you get old, you talk about all your ailments. And so, you know, you get a couple of people like Billy, and for a minute there, I thought he was pining for this award, by the way, the comeback, you know.
Well, you know, the world sport, all they do is fake injuries.
Oh, that's true.
They really don't get injuries in soccer. They just fake them.
That's true. That's very true. So, you know, when I thought about this comeback award, you know, we could have just given it to this old guy right here because he was playing pickup basketball with the team, which most of them were ladies, by the way, and he blew out his knee. And so when I saw Comeback of the Year award, who better than Coach Soderquist, right? Comeback of the Year.
Well, thanks. I thought I had a chance of winning it until I was thinking, who else would I be in competition with for this award? And then you came into mind. Because you've had 7 knee surgeries and 3 back surgeries.
Okay.
God didn't help you very much with those knees.
No, I didn't.
So I was like, shoot, I don't think I'm going to win it because you've come back pretty well from.
But we would tie in one thing. We'd come back as tall, skinny, lack of talent athletes.
Well, you're speaking for yourself. Now, I do have a stent in my heart. Do you
That's
have anything?
True. That's true. Heart,
you
with your heart.
So
and
I'm
with your
that
man
into.
Yeah.
Surely one of us can win this.
No doubt. We're disqualified. So the Comeback Athlete of the Year, other than Coach Soderquist, is the award that's given to an individual who returned to play this season after an injury or other life circumstance that required the athlete to miss time in training and competition. The award honors the persistence and determination that is required to get back to form.
Here are the nominees for the Comeback Player of the Year.
From women's soccer, Sarah Hill. Sarah came back from two hip surgeries for a fantastic junior season. She was a team captain and contributed significant moments and assists. From women's basketball, Sophia Mendoza. Sophia underwent surgery on her knee early in the fall and was finally able to take the floor for the Golden Eagles after Christmas break. She averaged 4.9 points per game, 2.3 rebounds per game, and 0.9 blocks per game. Sophia shot 50% from the field, and her presence inside helped the Golden Eagle defense. From women's soccer, Nicole Cosin. Nicole has come back from two ACL surgeries and had a fantastic senior season. She served as a team captain and contributed significant time in new positions in the back line.
The winner for the Comeback Athlete of the Year is Sophia Mendoza.
Yeah, I apologize. I apologize, Sophia, for the two old guys that came up here complaining about their ailments. Thank you for setting such a great example. What was it like to come back? How much work was it?
Well, it was really hard. I had to work like double to be able to compete with the team. So it was really hard, but it was fun.
Was it fun? Was it worth it all?
Oh, of course, yeah.
Well, you've done remarkably well, and again, congratulations on this and this award, and may you continue to recover and stay healthy, stay strong.
Yeah, I hope so.
Thank you.
Now, please welcome to the stage Melissa Bakke and Audrey Dearian as they present the Best Supporting Athlete of the Year Award.
The Best Supporting Athlete of the Year Award is for a student athlete who is a key player for their team, but who might fly under the radar to the casual fan.
His or her teammates know this individual's value, even though they may not receive many accolades.
Just think, where would Batman be without Robin?
How could SpongeBob have saved Bikini Bottom without Patrick Starr?
And how would Han Solo have survived space, as long as he did, without Chewie?
I don't know. But now we're gonna see the nominees for Best Supporting Athlete.
From men's golf, Trevor Barton. Trevor has provided consistency day in and day out for the Golden Eagles. He is the glue for the Golden Eagles and loves the sport and his teammates. You can usually find Trevor hitting ball after ball, day after day. From women's basketball, Brooke Barker. Brooke was the foundation of the team, a workhorse, very dependable, and a reliable teammate every day in practice. From volleyball, Beth Brankle. Beth was the anchor in both team serve receive and in back row defense. She had the most serve reception attempts of anyone on the team and led the team in total digs and digs per set. Beth also had success behind the service line, finishing third for most service aces. Her steady play helped the team's offensive production while frustrating opposing team players by digging up a lot of their best shots without much fanfare or recognition.
And the Robin, Patrick, and Chewy of our athletic department
is Beth Brankle.
Oh, congratulations, Beth.
Thanks.
Beth, is it true that your father is Steve Brankle?
Yeah, that is true.
Yeah.
He's and back there.
He is. What's it like day after day with a father like Steve Brankle?
Oh, you're Steve Brankle's daughter? Yeah. We have the same personality, so it's pretty fun.
Yeah. I was reading here. It says here that your play often frustrated the opposing team players. What do you mean by that?
I don't even know what that means.
You don't know what that means? Okay, did you get that from your father?
I think I did not get that from my father.
He frustrates me a lot, so he does.
he frustrates me a lot, too.
Yeah, he might even get on my nerves, but that's neither here nor there. What does this award mean to you?
Well, like they said, like, you don't get a lot of recognition. Usually, like, in volleyball, the hitters get all the recognition because they're the ones, like, hitting the ball down at the ground. So I'm the one hitting the ground.
Well, there you go. Well, thank you very much, and congratulations.
Thank you.
Now please welcome to the stage Brooke Barker and Sophia Mendoza as they present the Blooper of the Year Award.
Hi, again. So, hey, Brooke, you want to hear a joke?
Yeah, let's go for it.
So, what does a basketball player do when he loses his eyesight?
What?
He becomes a referee.
Okay. Anyways, the Blooper of the Year Award is given to a student athlete or a small group of the team that was involved in an unfortunate event.
These moments are not always funny at the time, but they tend to get funnier as the time passes.
Here are the nominees. Okay. Here are the nominees for Blooper of the Year.
From women's soccer, Nicole Cosin, in her second career Blooper of the Year nomination, has trouble with her heart rate strap. From men's soccer, Daniel Marulanda's ankle, or pride, takes a serious blow.
Nicole Cosin.
Sorry, Nicole. Sorry. Nicole, I don't know where to begin with this particular award. Do you want to walk us through it? Or?
I was just fixing my heart strap, and it's really hard to connect, so I just made the run and didn't realize. Okay.
Now, this is not the most prestigious of awards by any measure. How are you receiving this?
Well, considering this is my second one in 4 years, I think I'm doing pretty good, so.
So are you simply prone to, like, bloopers?
Yeah, I'm not the kind of clumsy sometimes.
Oh, well. Well done, you won the award. So, yeah, congratulations. Thank you.
Please welcome to the stage Tara Thomas and Alyssa Garza as they present the Game of the Year Award.
Wait, am I late?
No. What do you mean late?
Like, no, am I late to this event?
Tara, what? Are you late for finals, graduation ceremony, our annual drug test?
No.
The doctor?
No! Okay, I thought I was late for this event, you know, where I get to be in perfect fellowship with athletes I cheer for yet never speak to in person.
That's true. Yeah.
Okay. Also, because I caught a ride with Lindsay, and we left later than usual, and as always.
Sorry. For this, well, you're right in time. I was just about to announce the next award.
Oh, really? Well, what time is it?
Are you serious? You don't know the time?
No.
Like, time to get a watch?
Yeah, okay, I've heard that one before. No, but seriously, what time is it?
I don't know, it's like, probably like 7, maybe?
No, that's not what I'm talking about.
Okay, well, since you know yet again and trying to prove me wrong, what time is it, Tara?
It's game time! Yeah. Okay.
The game of the year...
The Game of the Year award honors a team for their excellence in a single competition.
The game or event was one of the big competitions of the year with a solid and sometimes thrilling performance by the student athletes.
Here are the nominees for Game of the Year.
Men's soccer's 1-0 win over the number 3 team in the country, Oklahoma Wesleyan, the highest ranked opponent ever beaten in program history. Interesting fact, during the 2014-15 season, JBU beat Oklahoma Wesleyan 1-0 when they were the number 5 team. Women's soccer. The SAC semifinals against OCU was a huge win. JBU won 1-0 as the team put in a remarkable performance on OCU's home field, showing a ton of grit in the final 10 minutes of the game as they weathered a final push from OCU.
And it ends up going into the side netting. So 1-0, John Brown takes the lead.
Women's basketball. The Golden Eagles opened conference season with a win over number 10 Wayland Baptist. This is Wayland's only conference loss of the season.
Take it away. Kimmy Dinas hangs on to it, swings it to Shamel, to Bailey Cameron, and she'll score. 0.3 seconds left. Two possession ball game. Cameron will get a chance for a 3-point play. Two possession ball game. What a game of hot potato that was between Jana Shamel and Kim Dinas. And JBU will come away with a win.
What a game.
63-58 is your final score as the Lady Golden Eagles pull a stunner here in Bill George Arena. And Carter, I can't believe it. What a way to finish this ball game.
And the winner of the Game of the Year is
women's soccer.
Well done, Kathleen.
Thanks, Billy.
Yeah. You know, winning by 1-0 is not like earth-shattering. Why do you think this is the Game of the Year? Like, why did you get this award?
I think it showed a lot of grit and determination. Came through a lot of injuries, kind of came against odds, and it was just a gritty performance by our team.
Gritty, that's very good. What went through your head when you saw that ball go in the net?
Not going to lie, I was like, did that really go in? But a goal's a goal. We'll take it.
I mean, I was thinking the same thing. It looked like it won.
We'll take it.
A goal's a goal.
Money, right?
Yeah. All right. Thank you very much, Kathleen. Yep.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs
out? Audrey! Beth! Bailey! Melissa! Kennedy!
Party was nice, the party was pumping. Hey, and everybody having a ball.
Let's go! I tell you don't get the ball, Kennedy!
And the ghost is going to be caught. I hope you won't show up.
Omaha, down!
I tell myself I'm my new
friend. Let's go!
280 cows calling them canine. Hey!
Hey, I'm Luke Moyer, and I'm the senior, the head coach of the new John Brown University athletics team, men's synchronized.
All right, there we go. Start up.
All right, Ricky Roberts, junior, assistant coach. This is the JBU men's basketball.
Hey, yo, it's Brendan Joseph, freshman. Hey.
Austin Fox, sophomore.
Zach English, junior.
Jake Otto, freshman.
Marquise Waller, freshman.
Joshua Rodia, sophomore.
Matt Leffert, junior.
Griffin Brady, senior.
Neil Martinez, senior.
Ben Smith, freshman.
Dwayne Hart, freshman.
Nate Anderson, junior.
You ready?
On my hood, I look fly.
Yeah,
I look good. Touch my swag, wish you could. I look fly.
Yeah,
I look good. On my mama, on my hood, I look fly.
Yeah,
I look good. Touch my swag, wish you could. I look fly.
Yeah,
I look good. I look good. I look good. I look good.
Yeah,
I look good. I look good. I look good. I look good.
Living day to day like everything's alright. Just waiting on that moment.
As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I take a look at my life and realize there's nothing left.
Bowling. I am a redshirt sophomore, and you guys are the first to know I am committing to JBU's men's synchronized swimming team.
At this time, we would like to recognize all second-year letter award winners. As your name is called, please come forward in the order your name is called to pick up your award. Eva Berry. Grace Cusick. Caitlin King. Claire Griffin. Claire Holden. Philip Todd. Kamal Folgum. Fernando Hurley. Connor Georgopoulos. Douglas Oliveira. Colin Smith. Adam Holt. Bailey Brown. Alyssa Arnold. Beth Brankle. Peyton Sager. Samantha Weber. Sarah Fry, Kim Dinas, Courtney Fine, Jaina Schammel, Mariah Knox, Thomas Bearden, Jake Brashler, Justin Riffle, Jacob Rogers, Aaron Stafford, Austin Fox, Annie Brown, Caitlin Collier, Abigail Danley, Jennifer Poole, Erin Haley, Rachel Bach, and Connor Bedor. Now, please welcome to the stage Nicole Cosin and Julie Whitlow as they present the Professor of the Year Award. These names were received by different teams, and then a vote by student-athletes determined the winner.
Julie, I feel like JBU student-athletes are professors' favorite students.
Why do you feel like that is?
Well, I mean, after morning workouts, we're always wide awake during class.
That is so true. You know what? We also sit in the front of the class, and we answer all the questions.
You are so right! We never, ever, ever miss class for a game.
You know what? Profs must love us because we get to give an award to our favorite person.
Yes. Student athletes are the best. Round of applause, everybody. But seriously, the Professor of the Year is given to the professor who has gone above and beyond to support JBU student athletes, both on and off the field of competition. This is the award, only award given tonight that is selective exclusively by us, the student athletes.
Here are the nominees that the student athletes selected for Professor of the Year.
Dr. Tricia Posey. Dr. Posey is the director of the Honors Scholars Program and an associate professor of history. Dr. Ted Song. Dr. Song is finishing his third year at JBU and is an associate professor of engineering. Dr. Jake Stratman. Dr. Stratman is the chair of the Humanities and Social Sciences Division and is an associate professor of English.
And the winner of the Professor of the Year is
Jake Stratman.
You know what's running through my mind right now?
I have no idea.
I'm just really jealous. Love to have that award. So what's your favorite sport to go in?
Oh, I knew you were going to ask me that.
I know the answer, but...
But it's not really fair because I don't know what teams nominated me, and I hate to... I was a college soccer player. And so I played many sports in life, but yes, yeah, I do. I love soccer.
All right. So do you have a favorite EPL team?
I knew you could ask me that too. I happen to follow one of the teams at the bottom of the table right now, Crystal Palace.
All right. Very good. Relegation.
Yeah, no, they're not going to be relegated. Okay. That's going to be all right.
Well, congratulations on this award. Yeah. Yeah. What's going through your mind right now, just holding that?
Well, I was a student athlete, and I'm not sure I always felt very supported. And I really care for our student athletes, and I care for all my students, of course. But there's something special about you to me because I know how hard it is. I really do know how hard it is, and I wish more athletes would take my classes.
All right, well done, Jake. Thank you. Congratulations.
Please welcome to the stage Coach Scott Marksberry and Coach Von Eschner as they present the Behind the Scenes Award.
You know, Coach, in our line of work, people always want to talk about motivation. So what would you say is your main motivation for coaching here at JBU?
Dog. I can call you Dog, right?
Yeah, sure.
The dollar bills. Yo.
You coach for the money?
Well, that and the love from the fans.
Okay. But when you're recruiting or you're preparing for practice, what keeps you doing what you do?
Dog. I know that the W's keep coming.
Okay, so make sure I got this right. What you're telling me is you do this for the wins?
And the dollars, yo, and... No matter what, yo.
And you've got money on your mind?
It will never be enough.
And the fans, every time you step up in the building, everybody's hands go up?
And they stay there.
Right. Got it. Okay. Well, the folks on this list, this next list, have a motivation that's often beyond our understanding.
And without them, dogs, many of our programs would struggle to operate. Here are the nominees for Behind the Scenes Award.
From men's soccer, manager Cody Phillips. Cody has served with Coach Marksberry all 4 years. Coach has this to say about Cody: I can't imagine any student possibly doing more for this department than this guy has done the last 4 years. We could build a slideshow of his impact. Two highlights of what Cody has done would be developing a very sophisticated stat-keeping program and designing and building a mount for the streaming camera, which has since been built for other SAC schools. From men's basketball, manager Drew England. Drew was very helpful in and out of practice, always asking for ways he could help serve the team. He was personable with all the players and acted as a spiritual mentor to many. From women's volleyball, Peyton Sager. Peyton was like having a third coach on the bench due to her familiarity with the program and what was expected from the players from a technical aspect, as well as from a character standpoint. Peyton provided timely insight to the coaching staff from a statistical standpoint that was very helpful in making in-match adjustments.
And the winner of the Behind the Scenes Award?
Cody
Phillips.
Well done, Cody. What's it been like working for Coach the last several years? This is your opportunity here.
It's something special, I'll put it that way. There are some days that are a huge blessing. There are some days that are... There's some good days.
Okay. Now, a couple of things have been said about you, that you developed a very sophisticated stack-keeping program. What in particular is so sophisticated about this stack-keeping program?
I don't know where to begin.
Thank you very much. The other thing that he said is that you designed and built a mount for a streaming camera. Now, what impact did that have on the team?
Well, from my understanding, the camera mount was able to hold a bigger, more sophisticated camera for better live streaming, so the quality of film is now better. And it's also on the outside of the press box, so now you don't get the windows in the way.
Very good. Well, are you excited about this award?
Yes, sir, very much. And I want to thank the team.
Well, thank you very much. Congratulations, Jeff.
Now please welcome to the stage Trevor Barton and Sam Greenleaf as they present the Breakthrough Athlete of the Year Award.
All right, since we can't follow that and we have the lowest GPA probably in all of athletics, I'm just going to read everything. The Breakthrough Athlete of the Year Award is given to a student athlete who performed at a level significantly above their previous seasons at JBU. Their breakthrough performance may have even surprised some people from the outside. This student must have at least one season of competition prior to this year.
From women's soccer, Hannah Poor. Hannah had a huge year as she stepped into goal for her team when Kristen Morency suffered a season-ending injury in the first game of the year. After mainly being a field player for her first 2 years, she consistently came up with huge saves throughout the year, with one opposing coach complimenting her by calling her a spider monkey in the goal. From men's soccer, Guillerme Barbosa. G went from one goal and one assist in his first 2 years to 3 goals and 4 assists in his final season. G played in every game and started 18 matches and was named second team all-conference. From women's volleyball, Alyssa Arnold. While learning right before the season began that she was the only setter on the roster for the season, Alyssa was asked to play all 6 rotations and quarterback the offense while also being told to stay completely healthy. She rose to the challenge and played at an extremely high and consistent level. Alyssa was the number 2 setter in the conference in terms of total assists and was ranked number 24 in the nation. She also ranked 2nd on the team in digs with 403, and in spite of being a bit short for a front row player, she was the team's 5th best blocker on the season.
And the winner is Alyssa Arnold.
Alyssa, congratulations. This is a great award. What's going through your mind right now with having won it?
I couldn't have done it without my team and all the encouragement they gave me the whole time.
Was there a lot of pressure put on you this year?
Yeah.
Now, it says here that you exceeded all of the expectations placed upon you. Were you aware of the expectations going into the year?
Yes.
And were they realistic or unusually low or high or?
Well, they're kind of high, but my team helped me accomplish everything, so.
Well, yeah. Well done. Congratulations
on
winning it. Yep.
Please welcome Kenny Crane and Abby Melby as they present the award for Best Play of the Year.
Hello, I'm Kenny.
And I'm Abby.
And we're going to be introducing the Best play. Best play? I mean, what's a play?
I think it's like that one time you passed someone the race.
Oh, yeah. Or like when Coach told us that secret play that Coach called us to go faster?
Yeah.
Got it.
Or the one time you actually crossed the finish line.
Oh, yeah. Well, anyway, the best play of the year nominees.
Ann Metz from women's soccer in the first game of the year. Her celebration might be the best part of it because it was the first goal of her college career.
Was waiting for the ball, and she headed in for a 2-0.
Well-placed header by Anna Metz. Headed from the left side into the right corner, right away from the goalkeeper's hands.
Marquise Waller's alley-oop dunk over national champion Mid-America Christian, assisted by fellow freshman Brandon Joseph.
Here comes Brandon Joseph again to Marquise Waller. Marquise Waller with the alley-oop.
Women's basketball against Wayland Baptist. At the end of the game, five players showing amazing teamwork to secure the win.
Jaina Schammel gets that one taken away. Kimmy Dynas hangs on to it, swings it to Schammel, to Bailey Cameron, and she'll score. 0.3 seconds left. Two possession ball game. Cameron will get a chance for a three-point play. Two possession ball game. What a game of hot potato that was between Jaina Schammel and Kim Dynas. And JBU will come away with a win.
What a game.
63-58 is your final score as the Lady Golden Eagles pull a stunner here in Bill George Arena. Carter, I can't believe it. What a way to finish this ball game.
And the winner is?
Marquise Waller.
Hello, Marquise. The alley-oop, that's something that certainly I could only dream of performing. Well done. What's going through your mind right now? How do you feel about this award?
It was just crazy. I caught it. I didn't think I was going to catch it, to be honest.
Okay. And it says here, alley-oop dunk over national championship, assisted by fellow freshman Brandon Joseph.
Oh, yeah.
You want to tell us what he did to assist you?
Yeah. First, I want to say shout out to my boy Brandon over there. Real deal.
How important was the assist in the whole thing?
Well, the assist, we got like the momentum of the game. So, like, leading into it, it just added a little more momentum, I guess. Yeah. And
Should he be up here helping you get this award?
Well, yeah, I think he should be up here, actually. I think he should.
Well, let's just say thank you and we're good. Right. Well done.
Now please welcome Griffin Brady and Nate Anderson as they present the award for Best Finish / Best Comeback of the Year.
Did you know we were supposed to prepare skits? What? To present skits.
What?
Yeah, so we didn't have a skit prepared, unfortunately. But there are a lot of best comebacks or best finishes of the year. And we'll explain what those entail.
Okay, so the best finish or comeback of the year is awarded to an individual, small group, or team for a phenomenal game-ending performance. This award might also recognize an unlikely comeback by a team or individual that trailed throughout the game. There are many great finishes throughout the year, and some just stand out from the rest. Some are extra meaningful because they occurred in conference tournament playoffs, and some will be remembered for a lifetime.
And the nominees are?
Ryan Williams from men's soccer. Ryan blasts the golden goal from 35 yards out for the win over Wayland in overtime at the SAC quarterfinals.
Williams.
Great turn.
Williams with a nice shot! Goal! Ryan Williams!
that is your top 10 for ESPN.
What an absolute brilliant strike from Ryan Williams after a lovely turn and a goal fitting to win any match, Carlos. After a relatively dry and sparkless match, what a way to finish it.
The biggest and the better players in the world show up when it's the perfect time. And tonight, Ryan Williams sends the ball to the top of the net. And I'm going downstairs. I want to interview Ryan Williams.
Women's basketball coming back from 19 points down to take the win against number 10, Wayland Baptist.
Got to make sure they get a good shot on this one. Don't want any wasted opportunities.
Here's Barker. To Bailey Cameron. Now to Schammel. Picks up a screen. Drops it off to Dinas. Dinas sets up for the three-point shot, and that's good. JBU takes the lead. 27 seconds left. The shot clock is turned off. JBU needs a defensive stop here to come away with a win.
Huge
timeout
shot
by the Flying Queen.
My goodness, Kimmy Dinas. What a shot that was. And what great ball movement by JBU. Everybody got a touch.
Men's basketball at Luke Moyer. Luke's fadeaway three-point winner against USAO on senior
night. Up two with 25 seconds to go. And they'll maybe try to bleed out the shot clock as much as possible here. Inside to Brady, and it's taken away by Bowie. Bowie lays it up, and it's tied. 89-89. My goodness. JBU will finish it out. Moyer will shoot a three to win it, and Luke Moyer buries it from downtown. Mobbed by his teammates, Luke Moyer puts JBU up 92-89. 2.1 seconds to go, and Moyer knocks it down.
Oh, it's back to us. Okay, and the winner is Ryan Williams.
Congratulations, Ryan. Relive the moment for us and tell us what it was like taking that shot from 35 yards out and the seconds afterwards.
Well, I kind of talked to Coach about it afterwards, and right when I felt the ball leave my foot, I kind of just felt like, well, there was no way that was me. I mean, there was times where I'd do it in practice, but in a moment like that, it's very rare. So.
Now, there's a lot of folks out here that don't really know what that feels like and may not know the importance of taking a shot 35 yards out. Could you want to explain a wee bit about that?
Well, I mean,
like, how hard is that
for the shot? Yeah. It's really hard. I mean, about 30 yards out. So
I can't. Okay, no worries. What's the longest shot you ever took and scored then?
That's probably it.
Well, fantastic. Well, congratulations. It's all on video, and you got the award. Yeah, superb.
Thank you.
Please welcome to the stage Corey Cole and Logan Hellinghausen as they present the award for Best Performance of the Year.
Hey guys. I'm Logan.
I'm Corey.
And we are presenting the Best Performance of the Year. Now, the Best Performance of the Year, okay, is given to an individual student athlete who made the most of an opportunity to compete as a Golden Eagle. This athlete deserved a tremendous performance in a single competition and made all Golden Eagle fans very proud.
And the nominees are?
From women's soccer, Sarah LaChance. Sarah scored 3 goals and added 1 assist against Texas Wesleyan in the quarterfinal game of the conference tournament. Her impact on the game changed the outcome of the game.
Wonderful finish there by Sarah LaChance. LaChance here again. LaChance with a shot. It's a goal! Glorious finish there from Sarah LaChance. Looking for a pass, she connects with Coulson. Great turn, onto LaChance. LaChance beats her defender. LaChance one-on-one, goal! absolutely wonderful break there by Sarah LaChance. She burst past Kaylee Hart and a calm finish with the left foot into the bottom corner. It's 5 goals for JBU.
From men's soccer, Adam Holt. Adam made 5 saves to preserve a clean sheet versus number 3 Oklahoma Wesleyan, which led to the program's first NAIA National Defensive Player of the Week. From men's basketball, Griffin Brady. Griffin pulled down 15 rebounds and scored 41 points while making 16 of 21 from the field in an overtime loss on the road at College of the Ozarks.
So Logan, I've got a friend who actually really wants to help announce this. Would that be all right?
I don't know, dude. He's a little nuts.
That's true. He did bite me earlier today, but he's a good guy deep down inside.
I doubt that, because last time I saw him, he was climbing a tree naked, Corey.
He's got a wild side, that's for sure.
He's a bit squirrely for me, but yeah, go ahead. Let's see it.
Oh my gosh. This is little Joey. He's here to announce the winner. Say hi, Joey. Hi.
And the winner is?
Was interesting. Yeah. Sometimes I wonder. Okay, so this is probably the best award I could imagine winning tonight. What's going through your mind?
I'm very excited to be here.
It strikes me as odd, and you might agree with me or maybe not, but that a goalkeeper actually got this award tonight.
Yeah, you know, nobody really likes goalkeepers, so for us to get some recognition, you know, that really means a lot.
Yeah, that's very, very true. So I noticed, and I'm sure everyone would agree, that a goalkeeper, there's an awful lot of like just standing around during the course of a game. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I chose goalkeeper because I don't particularly like to run. I'd rather roll around in the dirt, so that's kind of my forte.
Okay, now what's going through your mind when you see everyone else out there running all over the place?
Man, I'm glad I'm not them.
All right, well done, and congratulations on this award. Thank you. Yep.
Hi, we're at John Brown University's beautiful tennis facility this afternoon.
It's a multi-million dollar facility. You know, the school's really poured in a lot of money for it. And it's been huge on building the, you know, historic program that we have here at JBU. But what's more important than our multi-million dollar facility and these beautiful courts are the players that make up this team. All right, so we're gonna take a good inside peek at some of the key players on this roster.
All right, let's check it out.
Hi, my name is Grace. I'm from Wichita, Kansas, and I'm a sophomore at JBU. I love Young Life and Patagonia.
Grace, that was so pathetic.
Grace, that is so pathetic.
Hey, my name is Jacob Bach. I'm a sophomore here on the tennis team. I love sunglasses, froth, you know, bro tanks, you know, suns out, guns out. That's it.
Look at my down. 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 Look at my down.
Hi, my name is Fernando Hurley. I'm from Costa Rica. I only drink sweet tea, and I'm a little competitive.
Dude, what the heck?
I gotta close the window before I record, because New York don't know how to be quiet.
Hi, my name is Nathan Kuykendall. I'm a freshman and I'm from Oklahoma.
He's so cute. The cutest.
Hi, my name is Jess. I'm from Overland Park, Kansas. Currently retired right now. I gotta stretch my hips. I love chia seeds, Macs, and health food.
Blogging.
Hi, my name is Kamal. I'm from Lee Summit, Missouri. You can rarely catch me at practice because I have tutoring. Moots is my best friend, and I love to whip and nae-nae.
Are you looking to be a cross-country runner? Well, here are a few steps you can take. Carbs are the only real food group. When you get dressed for practice, always wear neon. Throughout the day, be sure to stay hydrated. And never forget to start the day with a bowl of ibuprofen. Always buy the ugliest running shoes. They should make a statement. There is no off season. So now that you've got these steps, you're ready for an easy 12-mile run. Wait, my GPS isn't loaded! Hang on. Oh, 2%. Almost.
At this time, we would like to recognize all third-year letter award winners. As your name is called, please come forward in the order your name is called to pick up your award. Karis Buff, Molly Pugh, Jesse Alexander, Taylor Russell, Hannah Poor, Sarah LaChance, Sarah Hill, Abby Melby, Cody Powell, Melody Williams, Benetton Lee, Cole Maurer, Daniel Marlanda, Marco Cardona, Hazley Pyle, Trevor Barton, Kent McDonald, Levi Nordmeyer, Zach English, Ricky Roberts, Miguel Martinez, Nate Anderson, Matthew Ledford, Drew England, Haley Gerke, Emily Pierce, and Audrey Macy.
All right, throughout the season, many of you were named All-Conference, and we'd like to take a minute to just recognize you. So when I call your name, if you would just stand up, and we'll give applause to all of you at the end. From women's basketball, first team, Bailey Cameron. You're already not following instructions. From women's basketball, third team, Brooke Barker. From women's basketball, honorable mention, Cody Powell. From women's soccer, first team, Justin Redman. First team, Sarah Fry. First team, Sarah LaChance. First team, Samantha Weber. Second team, Aspen Robinson. Second team, Julie Whitlow. From volleyball, first team, Audrey Darien. First team, Libby Blasingame. Second team, Alyssa Arnold. Second team, Molly Pugh. Volleyball, honorable mention, Beth Brankle. From men's basketball, third team, Griffin Brady. Honorable mention, Luke Moyer. From men's cross country, first team, Josh Uzelak. From men's soccer first team, Colin Smith, Douglas Oliveira, Giovanni Bajorda. Now I wrote that all out, Gio, to say it right. Nick, what is it again? Bejarano, I can't even read my writing. Men's soccer first team, Adam Holt. Second team, Ryan Williams. Second team, Guillermo Barbosa, G. And men's soccer second team, Will Simons. Let's give all these players a round of applause. There's also some folks that I'd like to recognize by standing for receiving regional recognition from mainly coaching associations. From the American Volleyball Coaches Association, first team all-region, Audrey Darien and Libby Blasengame. And from the same organization, honorable mention, Alyssa Arnold, if you guys would stand. From the National Soccer Coaches Association, all-region first team, Douglas. And honorable mention goes to Adam Holt, Gio and Colin Smith. Well done, guys. All right, we have three special awards that you guys have already received kind of notification of from the NAIA, but these are All-Americans, which is an extreme honor when you're named an NAIA All-American. So I'd like you to come up and receive your award as your name is called. From men's soccer, honorable mention, Douglas Oliveira. From women's basketball, Bailey Cameron, honorable mention. And from volleyball, third team goes to Audrey Darien. This next group is a very distinguished group, although I don't have something physically to give you other than we'll all clap for you as you stand up. But these are folks who got the NAIA Scholar Athletes, which is pretty impressive, a 3.5 cumulative GPA or higher, having to be a junior or a senior. So if you guys would stand and please remain standing as we recognize all of you. Men's cross country, Kenny Crane and Aaron Stafford. Women's cross country, Annie Brown and Aaron Haley. Men's soccer, Zeke Zumbro and Corey Cole. Men's golf, Trevor Barton. Women's soccer, Sarah Hill, Sarah LaChance, and Julie Whitlow. Women's volleyball, Audrey Darien and Libby Blasengame. Women's tennis, Taylor Russell and Crisana Saucedo. Give a round of applause for them, 3.5 GPA or higher.
Guys, remember when we did that header challenge preseason?
Yeah.
We had like 1,000 likes. You think we can do it again?
Let's try.
Yeah. All right, let's do it.
Wait, are we messing up?
What you doing? You need to back to me.
Money.
Next. Hey,
money.
Money.
Hey.
Money.
Hey, Bobby.
Oi.
Hey.
Hey. Hey. Hey. No, no. Hey. Wait, wait.
Mine.
It's all right. Sometimes we just get lucky.
Williams. Great turn.
Williams with a nice shot. Goal!
But guys, sometimes you get really, really lucky.
Finish it out. Moyer will shoot a three to win it, and Luke Moyer buries it from downtown. Mobbed by his teammates, Luke Moyer puts JBU up 92-89.
At this time, we would like to recognize all fourth-year letter award winners. As your name is called, please come forward in the order your name is called to pick up your reward, and then remain up front for a group picture. Audrey Derian, Libby Blazingame, Melissa Bakke, Krizana Sacedo, Kristen Morenci, Julie Whitlow, Nicole Cosin, Alex Farr, Claire Greathouse, Brooke Barker, Sophia Mendoza, Alyssa Garza, Tara Thomas, Lindsay Dodson, Shallon Orban, Max Gordon, Robert Rayborn, Sam Greenleaf, Kenny Crane, Griffin Brady, Colton Cheek, Luke Reimer, Aaron Estrada, Will Simons, Galen Bahadursing, Logan Hellinghausen, Guillerme Barbosa, Zeke Zumbro, Corey Cole, Cody Phillips, and Luke Moyer.
In 2011, a JBU alumnus made a donation to set up an endowed scholarship fund in honor of Johnny Brown Jr., the former president, chancellor, and the grandson of our founder. The criteria includes leadership, character, integrity, academic success, and Christian commitment, as well as the student athlete's success on the court. The 2016-17 recipient of the John E. Brown Jr. Golden Eagle Basketball Award is Jake Cottle.
Now, the next presentation was not in the program. In fact, it went on one sheet of paper, I think, that was handed back to the booth that said, at this point, Coach Marksberry's stepping in. And a little bit ago, when our esteemed athletic director saw that, I understand that the question was, would I approve of what he's going to do? Which I'm only moderately offended, but I'll be tough. So in 2006, John Brown University got a new athletic director 10 years ago. Since that time, as you can imagine, some things have changed. The Bill George Arena did not exist before that time. Soccer was only played during the day before that time. Cross country was not a thing before that time. Things have changed. And while a while ago, Robin The all-time winningest volleyball coach in John Brown University history was known as a volleyball coach and was known as a former student and known as a number of other things here. Over the course of the last 10 years and over the course of your time here, almost everyone in this room has had a chance to interact with her primarily as the athletic director at John Brown University. And so I thought that tonight it would be appropriate for us to honor 10 years of service for Coach Doherty as the athletic director at John Brown University.
You might think that the JB women's soccer team's favorite bird is a golden eagle, but it's a robin.
Thanks, Robin!
Thank you, Robin!
For all you do for the athletes, JBU cheer and growing the program. We love you.
I love you!
Congratulations for 10 years as the athletic director at JBU from the basketball team. Woo!
I forgot my lines. Ready? Robin, thanks for 10 great years.
Thank you for 10 years of hard work.
Thanks, Robin!
And so, Robin, we'd like to present you with a gift, a token, to commemorate this moment. And we do appreciate your leadership. We appreciate your support so much as student athletes, as coaches. We appreciate your direction that you offer to this program. And so please accept this gift from us.
Thanks all you guys. All you students is what makes this job fun. So thank you very much. So on to you tonight, because that's what tonight's about. So we've seen a lot of success in athletics, but we've also seen a lot of success in the classroom. And 9 of our 10 teams was over a 3.0 in the fall, and the last team was a 2.99. I so wanted to round you up, guys, but I couldn't. But so we are really proud of all of you. It's a bit, and we want to, and golf, it wasn't you. You were above a 3, so hey, congrats, golf. Way to go, Trevor. Now, if I can have Dr. Pollard and Dr. Beers come up and help me here with these scholar athletes. These are JBU scholar athletes, which have to be in their 3rd or 4th season of competition and score at least a 3.2 cumulative GPA. So if you will come up and if you will help these gentlemen, because all of you are coming at the same time, and let them know your name so you get the right plaque, okay? So, Trevor Barton, Robert Rayborn, Aaron Stafford, Kent McDonald, Levi Nordemeyer, Kenny Crane, Elizabeth St. Louis, Megan Taylor Russell, Krizana Saucedo, Brooke Barker, Karis Buff, Molly Pugh, Melissa Bakke, Libby Blasengame, Audrey Darien, Sarah Hill, Sarah LaChance, Hannah Poor, Alex Farr, Kristen Morency, Julie Whitlow, Corey Cole, Logan Hellinghausen, Zeke Zumbro, Miguel Martinez, Audrey Macy, Shallon Orbond, and Tara Thomas. Give this group a round of applause. 3.2 cumulative GPA. All right, on to the 4 final big awards for this evening. We're going to start with the Champions of Character Award. These awards are tough to decide. Our coaches vote on this, our coaches nominate, and then we all take a vote. These are students that give back, and we know so many of you give back. So on with the female Champions of Character for Dr. Pollard. She was awarded the Golden Eagle Award this year by her teammates. The Golden Eagle Award on her team is for the teammate who truly lived out the core values of the team. She puts her team first. She protects the culture of the team. She's actively involved in the JBU community with leadership roles in SMLT and as a captain of her team. Through SMLT, she was part of World Awareness Week and the Syrian refugee crisis. She's fantastic in the classroom, a model student athlete who serves her teammates consistently, invests in the community around her, and her character in every area of her life. Please help me congratulate Sarah Hill as this year's winner of the Champions of Character Award. Sarah, if you can just take a seat here and we'll do a picture with you in the... All right, for the Male Champions of Character Award. He's led 5 to 6 community sport camps for ages 6 to 15. He helped lead a week-long camp at High Point, North Carolina for high schoolers, engaging them in some devotionals while there. He did community service in Hinton, West Virginia through an after-school programs twice a week for 5 weeks. He assisted with informal community ministry with low-income, at-risk youth. He's a big part of the Camp Siloam community service with his team building a mountain biking trail early last fall. He helped lead chapels for the soccer team. He was a DNOW leader for Jefferson Avenue Baptist Church in Springfield, Missouri in December, working as the high school boys group leader. He works at New Heights Church doing children's ministry on Sunday mornings. He's a growth group leader. He's co-coach for a youth Siloam Springs soccer team. He's a community clinic age group leader for the JBU soccer clinics. And he spent his spring break on a mission trip to Honduras. He's a great champion of character. Congratulations, Logan Hellinghausen, men's soccer. Logan, if you can have a picture with Dr. Pollard and then Sarah will join you. All right, our final two awards tonight are for the Outstanding Male and Female Athlete of the Year. Criteria for these is SAC All-Conference, NAIA All-American, a statistic leader, significant contributor, school record, success of your team, and character of the individual. JBU head coaches vote on this. So our female student athlete was named to the NAIA All-American third team, the third in JBU history and sport. She was ranked number one serving player in the nation in terms of total service aces and service aces per set. She finishes her career being ranked in the top 5 all-time in total kills with 1,536 and in service aces with 221. She joins the very exclusive 1,000-1,000 club by amassing 1,536 kills and 1,217 digs over her 4 years. By the end of her senior year, she finished with either career high marks or second best career in every statistical category. Please congratulate Audrey Darien from Women's Volleyball. Outstanding Female Athlete of the Year. All right. Our male athletes, a 2-year letterman who was named NAIA All-American Honorable Mention. He was the SAC Defensive Player of the Year and his first team All-Conference. His performance on defense was key in helping his team be ranked number 13 in the NAIA in shutouts per game and 19 in the nation in goals allowed per game. Please congratulate Douglas Oliveira from men's soccer. This year's outstanding athlete. Before closing tonight, is Todd Bowden here? Todd, are you here? When you see Todd, congratulate him. He is going to be recognized in 2 weeks for 20 years of service to JBU. And I know you guys appreciate his joke at the beginning of the year, every year, student athlete all meeting. So make sure you say congratulations to him as you see him this next week. Second one, I'd like to I'd like to ask Doug Turner and the golf team to stand up, if you would. So back in February, I had the unfortunate news to tell these guys that we were not going to continue golf after this year. And these guys have risen to the challenge. I asked them to just go out strong and finish well, and they have stuck with it, and they have played day after day representing JBU well. And I just want to say thank you guys for the way you've represented us this spring, even under the circumstances. And to Doug, we want to say thank you for 3 years with us. Doug and his family are moving this summer to Texas. And so we just wanted to say thank you. And if everybody would just congratulate them for a year well done. So lots of great memories tonight, lots of great things. Before Kenny comes to close in prayer, we have one more video to show. After the video and the prayer, there's all kinds of snacks next door. Feel free to open these three doors, go on over there, enjoy yourself. You can either eat there, come back here. The JBU backdrop is back in the hallway. You can come up here and take pictures. Just have a great time fellowshipping with one another. So we're gonna run the video, and then Kenny, if you'll come up and close this, and then we'll be dismissed.
Nation to our Women Tell All special. This was our most dramatic season by far. So let's start with some of our most memorable moments with the ladies.
Hey Beck, there's something you gotta know about me. I'm a keeper and I'm number one.
The one, he's beautiful. I just go crazy every time I see him. Oh my gosh.
He's been to rehab twice already. Did you know that?
No.
They said that? Gosh, it was for my ACL.
Do you think he would like my hair in a braid or a bun?
Oh yes, no. Which color do I choose?
Oh my gosh.
What is Beck gonna like? I don't know.
Oh my gosh.
Kristen, will you accept this rose?
Oh, red!
Red card.
Yes, I will.
Jaspin.
It's mine!
Didn't even want your rose anyways.
Beck, I'm so glad you chose me for the one-on-one. I'm having so...
Oh my gosh, that's so hot!
I'm having so much fun.
That cold-hearted rejection at the end. What was that like for you?
Well, I mean, I've only been here for 2 weeks, but am I ever gonna fall in love again? Like, I don't even, why did I even come here in the first place? It was so embarrassing.
In the end, Beck found Coach Paulson to be his true love.
Sounds good.
All right, bow your heads with me, please. Father, thank you just for this night and just the chance to celebrate all the gifts that you've given us. God, I pray, Lord, that in this next year, God, Lord, that we would use our talents and our skills to further your kingdom and just walk in your grace. Be with us as we continue fellowship in the next room, and just be with us as we finish up the year strong. In Jesus' name, amen.